Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Dragon Age 2. In the last episode, we investigated our mother's disappearance, found some blood, followed it to the foundry, and now we're in halfway through the foundry area to try to find out what happened to our mother. That's what we're going to be doing. Let's start it off and let's get going. I think we're pretty much done now. Now it's going to be the next part of the stuff and chest. Can I click that letter? I saw it highlight. Did you? I know I saw it highlight. Or was it just because I was highlighting on something else? There we go. Okay. Well, on we go to find out. Oh, save icon. Here we go.
I was wondering when you'd show up. Leandra was so sure you'd come for her.
Mother always knew me best.
Yes, and she spoke so fondly of you. What a lovely, gentle woman. You will never understand my purpose. Your mother was chosen because she was special. And now, she is part of something greater.
Whatever.
You're crazy. I get it. Where's my mother?
I have done the impossible. I have touched the face of the Maker and lived. Do you know what the strongest force in the universe is? Love.
What?
I pieced her together from memory. I found her eyes, her skin, her delicate fingers.
Somebody is cracked out.
At last, her face. Oh, this beautiful face. I've searched far and wide to find you again, beloved. And no force on this earth will part us.
No snap. Time for doing the nasty. Not good. Oh well. We can kick their butts. Easy peasy. Let's do this, dude. So in this fight, we have to fight off possessions of each woman through the succubi or succubus, whatever you want to call them. Not too hard, especially since I'm playing on easy mode, but still. It is repetitive, though. So, that, you know, rinse and repeat, I think, 4 times, and then you fight the other dude, and it's over. Not that exciting. Yay for AoE effects! Good job, Sebastian. Now we have to fight Mommy. There's things up there? What the hell are they spawning up on stairs for? That makes no sense at all. Fenris, you got it. I have faith in you. And now we should be able to fight Rogue Boy as soon as Fenris kills, or Anders, whoever killed it. Come on, dum-dum. There we go. Yay! Right in the eye socket.
Mother!
Blech. She's a zombie! Watch out, she'll eat your brains!
There's nothing I can do. His magic was keeping her alive.
Oh boy.
I knew you would come.
You know me. I always save the day.
I always save the day?
Don't fret, darling. That man would have kept me trapped in here. But now, I'm free. I get to see Carver again. And your father. You'll be here alone.
Nah. I'm a big boy.
I'll be fine, Mother.
I remember when I first played this.
My little boy has become so strong.
Oh, when I first had the scene, I was so sad.
You've always made me so proud.
And I'm not going to admit to crying. Just say things happened. But it's such a bad scene. Oh. And now we're home and we have to be depressed.
Did you find her?
Uh-oh.
I'm sorry, Uncle. She's gone.
You were right about the flowers and everything. I can't believe she's gone.
You can say that over and over, but it won't change anything.
Why her? Why Leandra?
No, I can't tell him. Just better to just
Mother's
not
gone.
No.
Will knowing why ease the pain?
Nope.
No, it won't. It will always seem senseless, won't it? Where's the one who did this to her? Did you find the person who killed Leandra?
Nah.
Let's just say his killing days are over.
It won't bring Leandra back, but I'll take comfort in knowing that.
You do that.
Bethany needs to be told. I'll send a message. Hopefully it will reach her wherever she is. Take care, my boy.
His sword is cutting the bed. All the bed sheets destroyed.
I feel I should say something.
Or you could just come sit over and... nah.
I know you're not good at emotional stuff.
At least your mother loved you. Not everyone can say that.
Well...
I'm going to hold on to my memories of what she was, not the thing Quentin made of her.
And just think, you stopped him. Quentin's never going to hurt anyone again.
Now, come
I
over
think
here
no matter
give
what,
me some
she'd
smackers.
Be proud of you.
Yay, following the cue in a new quest. A letter from the Viscount arrived recently. It must concern a matter of importance to Kirkwall. And that's it. Oh, no, it's not. Mirror image. Aveline. Varric. Always busy. Always have something to do. Never have time to just chill at my house and be in mourning. Of course not. Hey, puppy. Alright, so let's go find out. I guess we can go to the pub first. I always like talking to Varric. He's pretty funny. And we will just confirm and just go to the pub. Yeah. It'll just be me and Varric having a few beers alone. Nothing fishy about that, right? I don't know if he gives me an extra quest or not right now. That's why I wanted to go talk to him.
And he then is? Hawk tore the door clean off its hinges, walked into the room, and... I guess we'll finish this later.
We will, huh?
Have you got a minute, Varric?
Of course, Hawk. Actually, I've been meaning to talk to you.
Really?
I hear you and the Rivaini have something going... So, what's going on, Hawk?
What? Are you jealous?
Well, I never thought you were the type, Varric. I'm flattered.
Hawk, I know I'm damned near irresistible, but you're just too high maintenance for me. Sorry. Listen, as your friend, I feel like I'd be doing you a disservice if I didn't
what?
Say something. Isabella is a great girl, but I think you're likely to get hurt. By which I mean stabbed and left for dead.
Oh, jeez.
In all the time you've known me, have I ever given you the impression that I was turned off by crazy?
Okay, point taken.
That was awesome. High five, Varric, high five. Isabella was right there. She could have heard you, naughty. All right. What's next on the list again? We have Aveline, I think, and Meryl. All right, we'll go talk to Aveline real quick. Real quick, Aveline. 1 second. And it says I have a letter, but we'll talk to Aveline first. Doop 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 doo.
Good day, sir.
Do 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 do. All right, Aveline, what do you want? Give me some sugar.
Hawk. Mm-hmm. I don't care what else is going on. We haven't spoken about Leandra. How are you?
I have a smile on my face. That should be enough for most people.
That doesn't work on me. I knew her too. I want to think my mother was like her.
Aww.
I just have flashes of impossibly long hair. But my father... Would you like to hear one thing?
Yes?
You've never talked about him.
My father trained me in all the skills he had been forced to give up. He spent everything to get me into Kaelin's service. Do you know what I remember? When he read to me, stupid things, dragons and heroes. He wouldn't turn a page until I reached over and took his hand. That big man made every step of the story my choice. I loved that. He died of the wasting in a Denerim ward. Those last weeks, I read to him.
Mm.
I had to take his hand to turn the pages, and I couldn't tell if he was too weak, or if it was the old game. He smiled at that, at his big girl. I don't know why I'm telling you this.
Because I asked?
Drink?
Let's do the long-worded choice.
A glass for those we've lost.
All right, then.
You better give me mega Benoit Dulac bonus.
And Leandra Hawk. Don't let anyone tell you when to move on. Take their hand and say, my choice. That's all I have. I'll miss her, too.
Mega bonus friendship points. Give it to me. Damn it! That wasn't even 5 points? I feel chipped. Now we have to go do Meryl. Blah. I think we'll have to do that next, unfortunately. It's not that I don't like Meryl, it's just that storyline just kind of feels misplaced with everything else that's going on. She's just like, oh, look at me, I have something that's unrelated to the story, come play with me. And I don't like how they retweaked her. I like the old Meryl from the, you know, well, that's another conversation for another day. So, unfortunately, I'm going to pause it here. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video, and we will continue with Meryl on the next one. Bye!